ओके
These are few of the services which our organization provides, like strategic planning and blueprint and all. And so first of all, the question is, what is project profile management? It's a strategic alignment process by which an organization's projects are evaluated, which means strategic alignment is basically some one few of the activities which the senior managers usually do to make the project perfect, which fits to their goals, vision and mission and objectives of the company. So the project profile management helps with that. And the importance of project profile management is it achieves to achieve the strategic objectives of an organization. And sometimes we have a problem with, there is a strategy, but there is a problem with the implementation. And the project profile management helps with maintaining the objectives of this. Few of the uses of project profile management. It is useful in identifying the potential return on project. In any project, if the company is investing, return of investment is very important. So the project profile management helps in identifying this ROI. And also to anticipate the risks, what will be the risks and what will be the scenarios that can come in front of us in the projects undertaken. PPM helps in that. These are few of the uses of project profile management, like helping in seeing the big picture and seeing what can happen in the future if this project is undertaken, and the transparency and governance and accountability with stakeholders. The objectives of project profile management is, the few of the primary objectives is to maximize the benefits from the project the company undertakes. And there are many projects, but selecting the right project is important for the company to get the benefit and to give the value for that project. And this is one of the objectives. Other objectives are like achieving the balance in project portfolio and setting up optimal mix of projects. Having the same projects is difficult, and it's very wrong for the organization to continue with that. So having a different mix of projects, the right mix of the projects is important. Alignment. Strategic planning. So as I said before, the strategic alignment is a process of where the senior leaders implement and monitor throughout the project cycle, which if whether it's meeting the mission and vision of the company, like how to get started, what are the SWOT analysis, objectives, and implementation. Blueprint is something that before doing the project, one has to map throughout the project, how to find it, how to define the project, what to do further. This is the blueprint. And adding values to every individual, team, and customer, how the values can be provided from this project, that is adding values. The operations. Portfolio is something day-to-day management we do, associated with the execution of tasks, time, and how much resources can be allocated. Project review is very important. One should review every project they're undergoing, how to plan the project, execute it, strategize it, how to implement it. And after the project is implemented, also a post-project review should be done. Sub-realization is development of the project and realizing what planning and production should be done, and in production, what production should be done. And from there, how to operate it further. Audit is one of the most important steps in any of the project. Once the project is in progress, audit should be done, whether it's going perfectly, whether it is doing it according to the financial circumstances of the organization, and is it ethical, and all these things should be done. And few of the approaches, need-based approach. Needs approach consider the amount of money needed to cover the expenses as well as debts and mortgages of the company. And ability is whether we have the ability to do the project. Resources, how much resource is possible that we can allocate? How much can we get? How much can we use? This is the resources. And finance, it is one of the major importance of the for the company. How much can be borrowed? How much can be invested? Lending, budgeting, and saving. These are something that should be planned beforehand and should not be a problem further. Controlling changes are systematic approaches to managing all changes made in the product and a system. All the changes should be documented and there should not be unnecessary disruption in the project. Governance. Oversight. One should oversee what is happening, what is going to happen. One should know this beforehand and have some plan for this. Guidance. Guidance refers to the advice or information provided by a person of experience, by someone who is experienced in the field to give advice and their guidance for the project. So, what is the role of the project profile portfolio manager? Portfolio project manager is a very important and successful execution of an organization strategy. Their role revolves around managing one or more portfolios, that is day-to-day management of all the projects, and develop management standard to guide the portfolio. They are someone who provide high-level overview of everything within the day-to-day management. And PMO includes managing the portfolio and establishing project management processes and standards. So the project profile management has some tools and techniques which we will see further. One is cost and benefit analysis. Every company should think about cost and how much benefit we can get before doing the project. Lower the cost and higher the profit. How to do this? These are few of the things. Decision tree analysis is a visual tool for qualitative analysis. Here, our PPM tools establishes hypothetical scenarios. What can happen? How it will affect the project? How to overcome this? We can know from this. And the scoring model is something that is analytical technique that combines both the quantitative and qualitative factors of judgment and weights it with scores. It scores the projects based on how it is going and the highest scores we can get to know. Estimated commercial value incorporates risk into the formula. What risk will be there? How to overcome this risk? This risk factor will also be incorporated in estimated commercial value. Objective matrix. It breaks down the high level organizational strategy into multiple sub business objectives. So to evaluate project based on the objectives, whether it is going accordingly, and assigns the score to projects as they align to each objective. So the five stages of project portfolio management. First one is set a business objective. This is a basic step where objective should be set to any project to start. And after that, one should collect and research all the information on the potential projects. What are the information that is required? How much resources are there? What is the financial standpoint of the company? All these should be known. And then with all the information we have received, we should narrow it down to some of the best lists and get the best projects. And validate this portfolio viability and initiate the projects. After validating and verifying the portfolio of projects and expand the high level data already collected, we should start initiating the projects. And the last one is to manage and monitor the portfolio. Once it's started, one should manage and monitor it continuously so that the project will be a successful one. So few of our ongoing projects of our organizations are virtual world tour for the kids and virtual world tour of amusement parks, zoos, and airports. These are the posters of our virtual tour. And another one is online aviation training program. Online career counseling will also be held. And we have three best books for successful career in aviation also, which is available online. Online blogger training program, online ground classes for pilots, branding for motivational speakers, and a resume, that is video resume ready for assistance from our company. These are our contact details. And our core team consists of Bhavana Agarwal, who is manager of FinTech, Shruti Priya, HR manager, Donia Elizabeth, marketing manager, Indrani Roy, HR manager. Manbir Kaur, Business Development Manager and Director as of today. Spandana H, Aviation Manager. And Sonal Sharma, Assistant Business Development Manager. Thank you.